So a hexagonal prism of 25 mm sides of base and 50 mm axis length rests on HP on one of the edges of the base. Draw the projections of the prism when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degree and VP at 30 degrees. So this is the problem he has given. Since he says that at 25 mm sides and 50 mm axis length rests on HP, so obviously we have to start from HP, that is from the base. Now, such that it is resting on one of the edges of the base, so edge which is resting on HP has to be perpendicular to VP, so that is PU and RS will be the two edges which are perpendicular to VP. So this is because since it is a hexagon, opposite to that is also a side, and that is it's in a from the projections of laminars also we have solved a lot of problems in such a manner that the side opposite to that is a side. Similarly, a corner opposite to that will be a corner for a even number of sides, even similar to a square also. So since he says that it is resting on one of the edges of the base, so the base which is resting on HP is PU and RS, both will going to be perpendicular to each other, perpendicular to VP. Now, since it is resting on HP, so all the edges are resting on HP. So when you look from the top view, ABCDEF is near to the observer, so it becomes visible. And similarly, PQRS is at the base, PQRSTU is at the base. So which is when you look from the top view, this is not being able to see because P is hidden by the point A, Q is by B, R by C, S is by D, T by E, and also U by T. So PQRSTU, all are hidden edges, so we are putting in bracket. Now identify the center of the prism, center of the prism, hexagonal prism, and then mark that point O and O1. So when you look from the top view, O1 is will go to be the axis. It becomes a point because that axis is perpendicular to HP, so parallel to VP. So I am getting a point in the HP. So O is near to the observer, so it is visible, and O1 is away from the observer, so it becomes invisible. So similarly, when you look from the front view, we can see the height of the prism, which is equal to 50 mm. So when you look from the front view, PQRSTU is at the bottom, at the bottom surface, and ABCDEF is at the height of 50 mm. So that height is seen in the front view. So from the front view, you measure a height of 50 mm and draw this horizontal line and mark the top surface, which is ABCDEF. So when you look from the front view, ABC is near to the observer, so A dash, B dash, C dash is visible. DEF is away from the observer, so D dash, E dash, F dash is invisible. Since O is at the top and O is hidden by the longer edge, that axis longer edge BQ, so naturally O dash becomes invisible. Similarly, O1 dash becomes invisible. When you look from the front view, PQR is near to the observer, so P dash, Q dash, R dash is visible, and STU is invisible, so S dash, T dash, U dash is in bracket. Now we will be writing the orthographic view. So here, since it is resting on base edge, so the base edge has to be perpendicular to VP. So you draw a vertical line first, then take any point on that vertical line, and then take a radius of 25 with using the compass. Draw a circle of radius 25 and identify the center as O, that is the axis O1. So then with O as center, take a radius of 25 and draw a circle. Then cut this circle, will going to cuts at the diameter of the vertical line, so which is at B and E. So you name them B of Q, B and Q, and E and T. Then with B as center, take a radius of 25, cut an arc on the circumference of the circle on the left side and also on the right side. See. Similarly, with E as center, cut an arc, take a radius of 25 and cut an arc on the left side on this portion, this side, and also on this side to get the point F bracket U and also D S. And similarly, A bracket P and C bracket R. Once you get all these 6 points, then name them with a dark line. So A to B you join, B to C, C to D, D to E, and E to F, and F to A. So this will going to complete the hexagon. So then join the diagonals. Join any two diagonals. we have already joined between B and E, join between F and C so that it will going to intersect at this point. So you mark that point as O, O1 in bracket. Now, since PQRS is at the base, so you project that PQRS at the XY line. So PQR is near to the observer. So P dash, Q dash, R dash is visible, and S dash, T dash, U dash will going to become invisible, and O1 dash becomes invisible. Since it is at the top surface is 50 mm above the base, so from P dash, Q dash, R dash, you measure a length of 50 mm and draw a horizontal line and join this as the becomes the rectangle. So here A dash, A, B, C near to the observer, A dash, B dash, C dash is visible, and D dash, E dash, F dash is away from the observer, so hence it becomes invisible. So since A dash, B dash is visible to visible is visible, you draw them. And B dash to Q dash is visible to visible, you dark them. And C dash to R dash is visible to visible, is dark them. Then P dash to Q dash is visible, dark them. Q dash to R dash, you dark them. Similarly, A dash to B dash, you dark. Then B dash to C dash, you dark them. So this is how we can complete the front view and top view of the first position. Now draw the projection when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degrees. Now, when you come to the second position, here, since the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to HP, so that means he has given the true inclination. So now we have to check whether the axis is in true length or not in the front view of the first position. Since the axis is parallel to VP, so this axis will be in true length. So that will be the height of the prism, which is 50 mm. So then the inclination given is also true inclination. So you reproduce the first position front view here by rotating at an angle of 45 degree such that it is resting on one of the edges. Which is the edge which is resting on HP? The edge which is perpendicular to VP. In this case, there are two edges which are perpendicular to VP. One is PU and the other one is RS. So if you are resting on RS, then you have to rotate clockwise. If you are resting in P dash U dash, then you have to rest it on and then you have to rotate in anti-clockwise. So since we are resting on P dash U dash, so we have to rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So how to do that? Since O dash, O1 dash is parallel to this rectangular face, A dash, F dash, P dash, U dash. So since it is a line, because this rectangular surface is perpendicular to VP, so you are getting a line here. So since this line and this line are parallel, so if you rotate this by 45 degree, then automatically this axis will also be rotated by 45 degree. So with P dash, U dash as center, by using the protractor, you measure an angle of 45 degree from this side and mark that. Similarly, from this side, you mark 45 degree and then mark that point. Then join from P dash to that point and extend. Similarly, from P dash to U dash, join to that point, then you extend on this side. So measure the length from P dash to U dash to P dash U dash to A dash F dash. You measure the length, which is 50 mm. From here, you cut an arc on this to get this point A dash F dash. Similarly, you measure the length from P dash U dash to R dash S dash. From P dash U dash, you cut an arc on this line so that you will going to get R dash S dash. So since you have the same radius, you from A dash F dash, you draw an arc and you measure the distance from R dash S dash to C dash D dash. Then from R dash S dash, you cut an arc on the previously drawn arc to get this point C dash D dash. Then join A dash to C dash to R dash, R dash to P dash, and P dash to A dash with the dark lines. Then measure the distance from P dash to Q dash. From P dash, you cut an arc, and similarly from A dash, you cut an arc of B dash to get this point B dash, A dash, and O dash. And similarly, you have to get here this point Q dash, T dash, and O1 dash. Then join these two with a dark line. So we have reproduced the second position front view by taking the dimensions from the first position front view. So now it is the second position front view is rotated at an angle of 45 degree to HP. The axis has been rotated such that it is resting on one of the base edges. Now to this we need to write the top view. So to write the top view, draw a vertical projector from A dash F dash and draw a horizontal projector from AF to intersect at A and F. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from B dash, E dash and O dash. Draw a horizontal projector from B to get this point. Similarly, O to get this point and from E to get this point E here. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from C dash D dash and draw a horizontal projector from C and D to intersect at these two points C D. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from P dash U dash and draw a horizontal projector from P and U to intersect at PU here. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from Q dash, T dash and O1 dash and draw a horizontal projector from Q to intersect at Q and from O1 to intersect at O1 here and from T to intersect at this point T. Similarly, draw a vertical projector from R dash S dash and draw a vertical horizontal projector from R and S to intersect at R and S. Once you name them, then again you join A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E to F. Similarly, join between P to Q, Q to R, R to S, S to T, and T to U, and U to P. Then join between A to P, then B to Q, C to R, D to S, E to T, and F to U. How do I know that? We can see here AP, BQ, CR, DS, ED, FU. AP means between A and P it is joined, BQ means between B and Q is joined, CR means between C and R is joined, DS means between D and S is joined, ET is nothing but E and T is joined, FU means F and U is joined. So these are the longer edges where I can see in the front view, we can see that A dash P dash is joined here. Similarly, B dash Q dash is joined here, C dash R dash is joined. Similarly, DS and ET and FU, but since that is not visible, so we are not able to see that. Now, once you get this, all these things have been joined with continuous thin lines. Now we need to darken. So we need to apply the condition of visibility. So how to apply the condition of visibility? The first condition or the first rule is all the exterior edges of the boundaries of the solids, all the edges of the boundaries of the solids will be visible. So which are the exterior edges of the boundaries of the solid? Since we have been joined everything with the continuous thin line, which is the boundary of the second position top view, AB, BQ, QR, RS, ST, TE, EF and AF. Since this will going to form the boundaries of the solid, so you dark them first. Then as you look from the top view, A, B, C, D, E, F is near to the observer. You can also see from, it is evident from here also, A, B, C, D, E, F, A is near to the top view, so near to the observer, so that is completely visible. So this will going to be the axis of the, when it is axis is rotated by an angle of 45 degree, so A, B, C, D, E will going to become visible. So B to C, C to D, D to E, you dark them. Then once you look from the top view, DCRS is the rectangular surface which is near to the observer, that is D dash C dash R dash S dash is, and it is a rectangular surface which is near to the observer, so it becomes visible. So you dark between D and S and you dark between C and R. Next, the left out portion is F to U, A to P, PU, PQ and UT. If an edge or a corner which is on XY line in the front view is always invisible, so when you look from the top view, so P and U will going to become is invisible because the edge is on XY line. So PU, you make a dotted line. So once you make the PU, which is a dotted line, from a point, if you consider P is not on the boundary, from a point, there are three, P is the point here, which are the edges which is emanating out of that? The emanating out of that points are PU, PQ and PA. So since PU is invisible, therefore PQ and AP will going to become invisible. So since from C to this it is visible, so from here you mark that PA is invisible. Similarly, FU you make it invisible, PU is already invisible, so PQ also you make invisible. Similarly, when you consider the point U, from U there are three edges which is emanating out of that. One it is UP and another is UT and the third one is FU. Since UP is invisible, UT also becomes invisible, FU also becomes invisible. Since the entire portion of ABCD, FU, ABCD, EFA is visible, so O is visible. So that is also evident from here. O is, since ABCD is the top surface, O is near to the observer, so it becomes visible. So O1 is in bracket because the some portion of the hexagon is invisible, so O1 becomes invisible. So then mark OO1 with a center line.